is momentum. Let us find out this, or let us study this today. Let us consider two objects, one having 50 kg mass and another having 5 kg mass. They are kept at the height of 2200 meters. Now, if they fall, they will fall with the same acceleration. Now, if I ask you to catch one object out of these two objects, which object you would prefer? I assure you that you would prefer to catch object with mass 5 kg. It is because the mass of the second object that is having is 5 kg, which is less in comparison to the first object having mass 50 kg. But in physics, it is not the correct reason. It is because the momentum of 5 kg body is less than the momentum of 50 kg body. So, we define as the momentum as the cross product of mass and velocity. We denote momentum with a letter P, and mass is denoted by the letter M, and velocity by V. So we get a formula for calculating momentum as P is equal to M into V. So we define momentum as the cross product of mass into velocity. And you all know that velocity is a vector quantity. This velocity is a vector quantity. So momentum is also a vector quantity. Okay. Now let's calculate the SI unit of momentum. We will first write the formula P is equal to M into V. You know the SI unit of mass is kg and multiply by velocity. The SI unit of velocity is mass per second. So the SI unit of momentum will be kg meter per second. Okay, kg meter per second. Okay, now let us learn how to calculate momentum. We will try to calculate momentum. So what we are learning now? We are learning how to calculate momentum. So let's imagine a person standing on a road, and suddenly what happens? A bicycle with mass 50 kg moving with the velocity 60 meter per second hits the person. And as commonly, naturally the person will get some injuries. Okay. If the same person who is standing on the road is hit by a truck of mass 2500 kg, then moving with the same velocity, then it is very common that a person may die or get serious injuries. Now, why this happened? Both the objects who hit the person were moving with the same velocity. Then also the person when got hit from truck is seriously injured. So let's calculate what happened. So case one momentum. P is equal to M into V. And P is equal to what was the mass of the bicycle? It was 50 kg. And what was the velocity with which the bicycle was moving? It is 60 meter per second. So let's multiply. After multiplying, we'll be getting 3000 kg meter per second is the momentum in case 1. Okay. So let's find out the momentum of the case 2. P is equal to M into V. So P is equal to what is the mass of the truck? It is 2500 kg multiply by what is the velocity? Velocity is same, that is 60 meter per second. So now the answer will be 150 kg meter per second. Okay. So this is the, see the comparison. In case one, the momentum is just 3000 kg meter per second, and in case second, the momentum is much higher, 150,000 kilogram meter per second. So in the case second, the momentum of the truck was very much higher. That is why this person got serious injuries. Okay. Now let's see. There is a question that does a stationary body possess momentum? Now let's imagine a car at the rest position. Okay, it is at rest, and the mass of momentum of the car, it is P is equal to M into V. So mass into what is the velocity? Velocity is zero here because the car is at rest. So the momentum will be 0 kg meter per second. So if an object is at rest, then its momentum is zero. So thank you. Stay tuned for the next upcoming video.